ZD-915 desoldering station, no brand name on it. And it's broken and I want to repair it because I'm repairing something else and I need this. But the gun is clogged and normally you can open it, but you cannot open it anymore the normal way. Hopefully we can open it with a screwdriver instead. We have a cable for the switch. All of that is fine. And we have a hose for the vacuum. And everything's coming out. After staring at it for a bit, I think I know what's the problem. Normally, you take this out by pulling this switch and then this whole thing can move back. So you can take that out. That switch is in there, like so. It holds that thing by the end of it, poking into a hole. But because this crappy plastic is broken, what happens when you pull the switch like you're supposed to open it is that the whole thing just, how do you say it, it does one of these instead of coming down all the way. It just rotates and then the thing is still stuck. The hope is that it goes down like that. That's because this plastic bit that's supposed to stop the button from rotating is all bent up and it was too small to begin with. So I think perhaps we can glue a washer on top of that and then the button has nowhere to go. Maybe even this bigger one if we cut it a little bit. Like so. That's actually my second attempt. The first one I thought I cut too much of it off, but actually, unless I want to break some of this plastic off, this is the one that fits. I broke off the plastic bit, so let's do this with the big one. I have super glue here. I think this might work. I have to hold it down for it not to go sideways, but this seems good. Now I'm just holding it together and it blocks. And now it's open. And now it's closed. Now it's open. And now it's closed. It feels crappy, but it always did, even when it was new. All reassembled, and to open it I have to press this forward a little bit, but it's okay I guess. Good enough. Now this comes out again and I can also put it back. I should have probably started with this, but if you haven't used one of these before, it's like a solder sucker and a soldering iron in one. You put this on a solder joint that you want to remove and then you press the button and it sucks the solder into that glass tube. And it's really neat and useful. And this is a really cheap one. And in the beginning I had this, I was really frustrated with it because I said about this being clogged, it used to clog up all the time. But over time I learned if I let this sit for like 10 or 20 minutes before I get started, it never clogs at all. So, yeah, it's got some learning curve, I guess. And it broke before, because like, there's a pump in this, and that pump uses these rubber membranes. And one of them got cracked, and I tried to glue it with silicone, no luck. So, I went to the aquarium store, and I found like a replacement pump assembly that has about the same membranes. Just like a friend who keeps fish told me aquarium pumps have this kind of thing, and he was damn right. They're exactly the same size. And then later I bought this bag on AliExpress with replacement membranes. They're a whole lot thicker than the original ones that came in there, but it took like 2 or 3 years of regular use before that became a problem. So I cannot really complain that much, I guess, and the spares are quite cheap. It comes with these pointy things to unclog it if it gets clogged, but sometimes that's not enough. Sometimes there's cold solder that gets stuck on this end. And what I found is, what you do is you take another soldering iron, touch it to that part, and then you can poke out the solder with this. It's a bit fiddly, but like, if you let this thing warm up proper, it barely ever gets clogged, so okay, I guess. And apparently we got another problem. It's not sucking. I don't know why. The pump is still working, cause...
Ow, 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 ow.
If I squeeze this hose... it's feeling it. But something's wrong. So until there, it is okay. It's got no trouble at that point. So either something's wrong here or that tube doesn't fit on there good. After staring at it for a while, I believe I found the issue. The hole in this rubber piece is supposed to seal on that small tube, but it does not. It's swallowed out and way too big. I think I have an idea how to fix it. This is a cartomizer. It's like the sucking end of a vape. The old school ones that kind of look like a normal cigarette. Some of those things, like this one, come with a little piece of rubber in the end. And I think this is silicone rubber. I poked it with a soldering iron and it does not melt. And that little rubber piece is an almost perfect fit onto that tube and even inside the plastic housing. Needs a little bit of convincing. And now that rubber over here doesn't need to seal around that tube, it just needs to seal flat against the other rubber thingy, which I think is a lot more robust. Let's see. That's more like it. Now I can demonstrate it. I have a PCB with a lot of fancy things on it. We're gonna take one of these off. A bunch of LEDs in one package. Sometimes a little fresh solder helps, but it's not strictly necessary. It does help to shake it back and forth a bit and let the solder joint heat up before pressing the trigger. That last one isn't totally good, I think. I think that's it. Ta-da! If you want to remove ICs like this from a board, it's really a must to have one of these. Otherwise it's a total nightmare to do. This one makes short work of that. Let's do this one. I can see which one it is. This one needs a bit of fresh solder. And now it almost falls out. Sometimes you get parts just falling out like that even. One more issue I've had with this thing is that sometimes the backlight on the display will flash at random, like when it's off. Even though it's like a hard power switch, I have no idea what's going on there, but it uses a cable like this, and the live and neutral on these cables is pretty much wired randomly. And after switching the cable for one that has live and neutral the other way around, it doesn't do that anymore. So there's that. Anyway, I've shown this thing and the issues I have with it, but I still highly recommend these things if you need a desoldering tool. If you're much cheaper, you can go for something like this. It's the same idea, but instead when you press this button, it sucks for a bit, and then when you let go of the button, it spits the solder back out, which is really kind of dangerous, but it works. At least it did for a while. Now it's broken, so the quality is shit, and it's 12 euros. This one is 90 euros, and there's a lot of variations of this kind of thing, different names on it, different colors, but I think they're all about the same crap, and all about around $100. And then if you really got good money, you can go for JBC or Metcal. They got like the proper version of this, which probably doesn't have all the problems you've seen today, but this thing gets me by. And I believe that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching, and see you next time.